Hello and welcome again to another Grumpy Old Gamer. Today we're going to talk about DRM and what's it good for? Absolutely nothing! DRM is digital rights management, and basically the way it works is it is a software protection scheme that allows developers to develop software so their software doesn't get stolen and hacked and cracked and all that stuff. And it puts a lot of restrictions on you, the consumer, for providing proof that you actually own the software. Which, if you ever sat down and read the EULA notification when you buy a game, it will tell you you don't actually own it, you're just sort of borrowing it. Mr. Don A. Mattrick, president of the Interactive Entertainment Business part of Microsoft, aka the side of the house that makes the Xbox 360 and the Xbox One, has left. Well, maybe he didn't leave, maybe he sort of pushed out the door. Why? What does this have to do with DRM? Well, let's go back a little way. Mr. Mattrick used to work at EA. He was one of the high-end mucky mucks over there. He left EA and went over to Microsoft. He literally turned the company around. And he was so good at what he was doing that he brought the Xbox portion of Microsoft out of complete failure. In Fortune magazine in August of 2011, they named him as one of the smartest people in tech. He was on top of CNN Money's top 10 brilliant technology visionaries. Okay, so he goes from EA, where they had the culture of DRM is awesome, and he moves over to Microsoft and says, yeah, let's make DRM awesome over here too, guys! And he talks everybody into making Xbox One completely DRM dependent. So what ends up happening is the Xbox was supposed to log in every day within 24 hours and check to see whether or not you had legal copies of your software. If you didn't, you got a brick and you're not gonna be able to use your Xbox anymore. That went really well for EA, who still has this idea that DRM is just fantastic and this is the best way we control our property while it's out there. Everybody remember the fiasco that happened with SimCity? DRM's not a great idea, folks. It does protect you to some extent, but with this protection, it takes away all your rights. Just like when you go to an airport and you go to get on an airplane. Back when I was younger, you could just walk on an airplane and sit down and smoke a cigarette. There's no security checks. Now they check you literally up your ass. And because of that, you're more secure, right? When you're on the plane. Now I feel all warm and fuzzy and I'm secure. But what did you just give up? You just gave up the fact that some guy just had his finger up your butt. But now you're secure, right? So finger up the butt equals security. DRM is exactly the same thing. It's very secure for the company. They can feel warm and fuzzy like this stuff, the software is out there and we're letting people use it. Great, because it's super protected. But for that, they're making themselves completely alienated and hated by the people that they're selling the product to. Ah, EA has their finger up my ass again. So SimCity did okay, but it's still a mess. And most people I know don't even want to bother playing it. I just did a poll the other day on my own, asking my friends, of the following systems, which one will you buy? And I sent it out to about 200 people, 200 of my friends. I really do have 200 friends. They all came back and said, of the systems that they were going to buy in the upcoming year, Wii U was third place, Xbox was second, and PlayStation 4 was first by a vast majority. Point that I'm trying to make is people don't want DRM. That kind of crushing security does nothing but ruin the economy. So my advice is knock it off with the DRM if you know what's good for you. Hey Joey, that's a really nice job you got over there at Xbox. I would hate to have to see you kind of, you know, disappear. Just deal with the fact that somebody's going to steal your stuff anyway and put it out there for the people that are willing to pay for it. Because you realize that DRM does nothing other than cripple your own player base, right? If somebody's going to want to crack the software, they're going to figure out a way to crack it. And yes, if you make it server-side where they're going to have to check in every day to verify whether it's legal or not, that will slow the hacking groups down, but it ain't going to stop them. They're still going to figure out a way to make an emulator, and then it's going to work anyway. So all you did was just piss off the people that really wanted to pay for your game to begin with. That's all I have time for today with my rant. This has been the Grumpy Old Gamer. Talk to you soon. I love you. Bye-bye.